Welcome to another tutorial in my tutorial series using CAS, Computer Algebra Systems for Mathematical Technical Applications in Civil Engineering. This special tutorial is an introduction to MATCAD Prime. So what will we do in this tutorial? Let's first have a look at the result of this workshop. And here we are. I think in my last tutorials so far, I used more examples from structural engineering. And here I have an example from building physics. Yeah? And so we would like to calculate in this worksheet the thermal resistance R, the total thermal resistance, I call it here RT, and there may be more known value, the U value or the terminal transmittance. Yeah. What is given? Given is the thermal conductivity K with regard to the material of each wall layer. Here you see an example for a wall structure. Yeah, we have different layers. Yeah, we have an outer and an inner side of the wall. And here are the layers of the wall, and each layer has a certain material, and each material has a certain conductivity. We will insert a picture of the wall, but we can also insert a table as a picture in MATCAD, maybe to show the structure in a table view. Yeah, then it's also given the wall thickness and the surface resistance for inner and outer phases, RS1 and RS2. So as I said already before, I will show you how you can insert pictures. And then this is actually just here, this is just repeating from the things we have done so far in the other tutorials, but here it comes something new. And this is how you can input such a layer structure, a wall layer structure. And for this, you can use vectors or tables in MATCAD, and this I will show you here, because each layer has a certain thickness and also a certain conductivity, and of course we have to keep the structure, and the best way for this is to work with tables or vectors in MATCAD, and this I will show you how you can do this. And here we come up to the calculation of the demanded output, and here are the formulas. And of course, if we use some vectors, then we also have to take something in consideration, how we can calculate with these vectors. And this I show you here, yeah, how we can make this this certain calculation we need to calculate this the terminal resistance. I'll show you some different examples how you can do this with vectors. And then at the end, this is just some easy calculations. Okay. As I've done this before, of course, I don't want to bother you with too much text input. So we have a template so that we can concentrate on the most important parts of this tutorial. And we will start. So the text is already here, so we don't have to insert the text. So let's start to insert the pictures here. So I place my cursor at the position where I like to have my picture. And now, Just go to the mass register card, and here we have the image icon. Give it a click, and here we have now this button. We have to click on it to open a file dialog, and here we can select our pictures. I have already created them. If you are interested how you can create such kind of pictures, if you use, for instance, Microsoft Visio for your drawings, then please look at another tutorial in this channel. Here I don't want to go in too much details. I just select the picture, click open, and here we are. The picture a little bit too big, so let's downsize it. Here I have those grips, and here I can click at this grip, and here I can just downsize it. Maybe it's look like this. Yeah. So the next one is a table, and maybe I give already a little forecast to other tutorials of a higher MATCAD level. Actually, if you like to insert tables like this, because this table is created with Excel, you have some better possibility in MATCAD, and you find this here. input output, and actually you can insert, you can link your MATCAD worksheet directly with Excel. Yeah, you can, of course, you can show a table, the table format in MATCAD. You can, but you can also read data from Excel into your MATCAD sheet for your calculation, and you can also export your calculated data from MATCAD to Excel, and then you can continue your calculation in Excel, for instance. Yeah, because actually Excel is a table calculation software. Yeah, and it has its strengths. Yeah, when it comes for table calculation, but MATCAD is not a table calculation software. It's actually a computer algebra system. This is something else. Yeah, but with this component, you can easily link those two software systems with each other. But this will come up in another tutorial, because now we are in a basic course, and so we just insert this table as a picture, yeah, into MATCAD. To do so, let's go back to the template, and here again I click where I'd like to have my picture, go to this mass register card, and then image, and again select the image you like to insert. This I created already from Microsoft Excel, such a PNG file for this table, and now I can insert it. This is the quick and dirty way. Of course, there is no link now between this table here and then later with our input values. Yeah, the better way, but I will show you later. This is not good for a basic course, is to link MATCAD directly with the Excel file. Yeah, then you can change the structure of your wall in the Excel, and it will automatically update in MATCAD. But this is not the topic of this worksheet. I just want to mention it, yeah, that you don't think that is inserting pictures of your table in MATCAD is the only way, yeah, to show data from MATCAD. This is actually not a good way, but in our case, it should be the best one. So, okay, so far about this. And now let's start with some new things, because I would like to insert, or let's start another way. How can I implement such a structure of a wall in MATCAD in a good way? Yeah, because here in those two values, K and L, the conductivity and the thickness, they are linked with each other. Yeah, because you have here, see, that's just a table. You have for the rendering layer, yeah, you have such a certain value which belongs to the thickness, and so on. Yeah, and of course, if you have even more layers, then it wouldn't be a good idea to make for each value individual variable. Yeah, and here comes vectors or tables into the game. Yeah, this is a good way to implement complex data, or data which belongs together into your MATCAD algorithm. Where you find it? You find it here in matrices and tables. And here we are. And let's start with a table in our case here. And here we have to select how many columns it has and how many rows. And in our case, we have four rows. So let's do it like this. So now we have our table inserted into the worksheet. Here you have to give it a name, yeah, for the column. And the first name is L. For the thickness, and K here for the conductivity. Then you have also, if you want, you can also set up the units. The thickness will be in centimeters, and the conductivity will be in watt times no watt per meter times Kelvin. Please don't forget the K, the multiplicator. Yeah, so now we have the units, and now you can add the values. It would be 2 and 0.87 for the first for the rendering layer. Now 5 centimeters for the board. Yeah, and it's 0. This one, oh, again, I did some mistake with the shortcuts. Be careful if you have lots of shortcuts in MATCAD, and If you type the shortcut, then it will be activated like I did here. So, and here it's 20 centimeters for the reinforced concrete, and this is 2.1. And the last rendering will be 1.5. And here we are with 0.87. Okay, here we are. So now we have, we use this kind of structure to, or the table, let's say a table, to build up such a wall structure in MATCAD. And but it looks, it is a table, but what you created actually is just two vectors, because the vector L, yeah, for this column, and the vector K for this column. Yeah, if I want, would like to work with this, then I can say L and evaluate it. And here we are. Here we have our thickness in a vector. And if I'd like to change it to centimeters, now we have it in centimeters. Yeah. And what is good, in, if you use it in this form, then this belongs together. You have only one variable, yeah, for all the thickness of the wall. Yeah, and on, only one variable for all the capacities, yeah, of the wall layers. And but how can we, how do you have access to the individual values? Yeah, for instance, if you like to have this 5, yeah, how you can access to it. And for this, you can use an index. Yeah, I mentioned already the index several times before. Every time when I use some subscript, I always said, please don't mix this up with an index. Yeah, and this time it's the first time in our course that we can really use an index, and we have it here. And the index, with the index, you can address each individual value of a vector, or later maybe also of a matrix. Yeah. So let's at first write the name of this variable. Yeah. This variable is not a single scalar, not a single value. It is actually a vector, and if you like to have access not to the whole vector, only to a single value, use the index here, and then you can number it. Yeah, the first value, the first index is this value, the second and the third and the fourth is this one. So let's try the second one, and now evaluate this, and here we have this 5 centimeters. Yeah, and if I use, for instance, fourth is this one, and if I'm if I'm outside my vector, let's say 5, then I get an error because it's this vector is not big enough here for 5. When it comes to index, I have to mention the constant, the system constant. This is where it is here, calculation. This is the origin. Yeah. And the origin actually is a system constant which tells MATCAD with which number you like you start your index in your vector or in your matrix. Yeah, actually the default is, if you use a normal worksheet which comes with MATCAD, then default is 0. Yeah, I prefer actually number 1 because in my Excel course we also have the all the tables start with the index 1, and so that my students will not mix this up or become too much confused, I use the same index like in Excel. In Excel, by the way, you cannot change this so easily. Yeah, in Excel, it is actually, if you work in a normal worksheet in Excel, then it's always 1. Yeah, and here in MATCAD, I like to be consistent to Excel, mainly because in some later examples, if we have a higher level in MATCAD, then we, of course, we would like to try here this Excel component, and then it's always, if you directly communicate with Excel, then it's also easier if you use the same origin in Excel and also in MATCAD. But I have to mention it, yeah, the default of MATCAD is actually 0. So be careful. As long as you use my templates, then of course I always use for the origin the number 1, yeah, but if you use some other templates, then, and you would like to use the same workflow as I do, then you have to change your origin to 1 as well. So here is this is the origin, and so maybe I can show you what happens if I change it. Yeah, so if I change it to 0, then this means that my first index is not 1, it is 0. Yeah, see, then it's here, this value is not 1 anymore, it's 0. And the last value is not 4 anymore, it is actually 3. Yeah, like this. Yeah, so 4 will not work anymore. Yeah, in my opinion, also in MATCAD, if you use index one or the start index one, I think it makes also a little bit easier, yeah, to, in my opinion, yeah, to work with the index. But I have to mention it, the default in Medcat is zero. And also, if you go to other CAS software, I think it's also mostly zero there. But actually, I'm not sure, but I'm sure that in some programming languages, if you work with arrays, then the origin is, as far as I remember, also zero. Yeah, that's why it is not so seldom, yeah, to work with zero origins. That's why I'm a little bit I mentioned it that that if you can, you can change it, yeah, and but you have to take this in consideration. So let's change this back to one, and okay, we talked about this origin, which is really important value or constant if you work with matrices but all and vectors. Okay, so far so good. Let's delete this and start our calculation. So yeah, when it comes to the terminal resistance, actually we have to divide our thickness with the how was it called with the compacity, sorry, conductivity, yeah, and where is it here, and then we have to sum it up, yeah, and but there's actually a quicker way, but let's start with the normal way, like you would also do, like you maybe would do this in Excel or in some other software, yeah, this one here. So I will show you some possibilities how you can do this, yeah. At first is if you sum up some calculations which with vectors, then you can declare a range variable, yeah. So let's do it here. The easiest way is to make it fixed. So maybe call the range variable. Now I'm here in this text field, and I enter here my range variable for the index. So I go to the mass register card, and here I enter this mass region, and here I can give it a name. Let's call it E. Yeah, let's be consistent to our table here. We also call it E. So let's call it here E as well. I, sorry, I as well, and declare this variable with the shortcut for definition. And we could say if this table is fixed, it starts with one and ends up with, oh, sorry, by the way, here is our range variable. Where is it here? Yeah, this is our range variable. Yeah, you have a start value, then 2 points, and then the end value. And of course, you can use this. You can enter such a variable from here. I use the shortcut, so just 2 points here, and then the end value. This you can do, and maybe just show the range variable how it looks like. If I evaluate this, here we are. We have our 1, 2, 3, 4, and the index values. So the disadvantage if you do it like this, that if you maybe change your vector, maybe you add one layer or you remove one layer, then you change its size. And then this does not match anymore. Yeah, this is also again could be an error. Yeah. So and the other one is, but this is not that important. But I can also mention it. It will only work in a worksheet where you use the origin number one. Yeah. If it wouldn't be zero, then you have to write it in that way. So it has to look like this. Yeah. And that's why I actually prefer another way to define the range variable, which is more general and which is also dependent on the size of this vector of this table. Yeah, and this can look like this. Yeah, I start with the origin. Sorry, origin. So you have to type it down with big letters. And then again, 2 points. And then I use a built-in function to find out which is the last index of this vector. It doesn't, because of this table, so they are linked with each other. So it doesn't matter if it's L or K. So last. Okay, this is actually a built-in function you find. Where is it? Here. And you can go to, where is it here? Yeah, vector matrices, and here you find the last index. Yeah. But please don't mix this up with length, yeah, because in our last index says only which is the number of the last index of your vector, and length is actually the size of the vector. Yeah, I will show the difference because this is not the same when it comes to the origin. So let's just finish this. You see now it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it works, and if I change the origin, it will still work. Yeah. Where is it here? Calculation. Let's go to 0. You see, it's also then it starts with 1 and goes up to 3. And if I would add some row, let's go to matrices, and here that's, let's say I would like to insert a row, and here just enter some values, 3 and I don't know 5, and here we are. It also changed the count of index. Yeah, you see, this is actually not so easy to read. Yeah, but it's quite so it will easily change. Yeah, later. Yeah, if you it's quite flexible. This was what I was looking for. Yeah, so it's up to you what you prefer. Yeah, this one or this one. Yeah, and I wanted to tell you the difference between last and length. So maybe let's do this here. So let's make here so. Let's insert this function, this built-in functions. It was here, and here, let's say this was last, and let's say k. Yeah, actually, it does. Oh, sorry, I have to evaluate this. Yeah, this is 4, and now length. Again, we can go to vectors, matrices, and the length was here. Okay, so if the index is 0, yeah, in our case now it's 0, then it's not the same value because the last index is 4, but the number of values in the vector is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so there is a difference. If the index is 1, then it doesn't matter. Then you can use last or length, it will be the same. That's why I said already some minutes ago that actually, in my opinion, if you work with an origin of 1, it is easier. Yeah, in my opinion. But maybe if you talk to some other guys or some other teacher, maybe they prefer only 0. Doesn't matter, yeah. But you see, in this, if you change the origin, then you have to be always then it makes a difference, yeah. If you use the last function or the length function. So far about this. So let's delete this. So and now we can talk about how we can use this for our calculation, yeah, because you have to sum up those values, yeah. And okay, the first way is to use this range variable here. So I click behind this, and again insert my mass region, and now I go to the operators, and here I find this summation, and give it a click. And I have to name the parameter I like to calculate. So you can also do this afterwards, and I call this R. This is the terminal resistance, and here I can take this. I have this sum operator. I have some placeholder for the index. The index is already declared before, so I can use it here. I don't have to do it in this placeholder. So I just name it here, and here I enter the term I like to sum up, and this is actually L, and index I, and here, and I divide this, get out of the index, yeah. Otherwise, let's zoom a little bit, my cursor is still inside the index. If I make the division now, then I'm still inside my index, so be careful. I get out, yeah, with the arrow key on my keyboard, and now I make the division, and it's k, and the index, where is it here, also I, yeah. So here I declared my range variable, then I use it in my sum operator here, but I also have to link this with my vector, yeah, that I use the index in my vector. And this is like a for loop, yeah. We talk about for loops later, but for those of you who maybe you know already programming, yeah, this is like a loop variable, yeah, this sum operator. So now we can evaluate this and just change the unit to the unit we want. So I just copy it to save some time, and here we are. Yeah, this is, oh, this was not good. What was wrong? Okay, actually I just stopped the record and tried to find out what was wrong. And you sometimes it could happen, yeah, if you just copy and paste the units, then it could lead to some troubles. And so in this case, just enter it manually. So I delete the default unit, and now I insert it manually. I click here the placeholder for the unit, and it's meter, square meters. Make sure now I'm get out of my exponent, and now times Kelvin, and now with my space bar on my keyboard, I expand my cursor, and now I make a division and enter watt. And you know, if I click outside, then it's okay. Yeah, be carefully. Sometimes it works, yeah, but sometimes this could also lead to some trouble, yeah, because this is actually not the unit here. This is just how can I say, this is just because it's not blue, you see. Yeah, this is actually only some stupid formula. Yeah, you can, for instance, you can also enter with those bolded equal sign which we have here. You can use some stupid formula which will not evaluate it, yeah, in MATCAD, and this I have done here, yeah, to make it easier for you to enter the formula, and also for me in this tutorial. But when it comes to units, you should be a little bit careful. Yeah. So, okay. So let's do another possibility. Let's show another way how we can do this. Because here in this workflow, we declared our range variable before, and then we can use it. This is quite useful if you have not just one operation. Yeah, where you need this variable. Maybe you have several kind of operation like this, and then it's quite efficient if you declare your range variable at once, and then you can reuse it again and again. But in our case, we have actually only one operation like this, and in this case, we can also declare our range variable already in this directly in this sum operator. Let's do this here. Yeah. So let's go back to math, then R and declaration symbol. And now let's use the sum operator you find here. And now we can use the placeholder to declare our range variable, or for our index, it is I. But here in this operator, we don't have to use, we should not use this this declaration symbol. Here we have to use this bolded equal sign, this one here. I don't know why, but just do it. If you know it, then, oh, maybe it is, or maybe it's just a normal equal sign. Ah, a normal equal sign. Yeah, it was like this, the normal equal sign. And it's actually one or origin, as you prefer. I use origin. Origin, I have it. Yes. So here we are. And then here you can say last k, for instance. So we do the same declaration like here, but we do this in this operator. Yeah, and then just can copy it here from here, and then evaluate this and so on. Maybe now we can make copy and paste, because now we have a really units, because you see that it's blue, that wasn't blue. Yeah, let's give it a try. Maybe now we can use it. Yeah, it works. So again, yeah, if you have several, if you have to make such operations several times with the same range variable, yeah, then it might be useful to declare the range variable once, and then you can reuse it again and again in different some operations are also we can also, by the way, we have also here this product operator. Yeah, it works in the same way. Yeah, but in our case, actually, we have only once this sum operation, so there's actually no need to do this to do this before. So we can also do this directly. Yeah, but it looks not nicely. Yeah, of course, you can also change this to e equals one, and then here you can change this to four, but then it is not linked anymore to this table here. Yeah, this you have to take in consideration. Yeah, what is important for you? Yeah, if it automatically updates, if you resize or downsize the table, then you should use this last function. Yeah. Okay, and if you want that your worksheet works also with the origin 0 and 1, then you have to use this expression here. But anyhow, as I said before, this is your decision. Okay, there's another possibility how you can do this. And I mentioned this already. If you don't like this, then let's just copy it and make it fixed. Maybe if you like to, it's for documentation purpose, it might not look so nice here. So you can also say, okay, let's do it like this. So equals one, and here last in our case four, and here we are. Maybe let's delete this last row here. We can go to matrices and tables and delete the row because I just inserted it to show you that it will change. So we are now here. Here we are, and this looks actually better. Yeah, if the documentation purpose for you is more important, yeah, and you want really has have to a nice documentation, and it's not. And you don't want to change it later, yeah, then this would be a better purpose. So the last possibilities, which works also in our certain case, is that actually we can use the dot or scalar product. Yeah. And this makes it even easier because then we don't need actually this the sum operator. Yeah. And in this case, it would look like this. Let's go to mass, and then type the letter R, then the declaration symbol, and here we just write down the formula for the scalar product, and this is actually L times K, yeah, K. But in this case, it's not a multiplication; it is actually a division. But we have to write it this way because it's a vector, and to have this product, yeah. But now it's not a product; it's actually a division, so we have to say it should be exponent to minus one, and so we made from this product we made a division, yeah. And with this we can also get the same result, yeah. If you please, if you don't know what's a scalar product, so please go to Wikipedia, or the, I think in English also called dot product, yeah. And then you see it's also it's something like this, yeah. You sum up this the product of the two vectors, yeah, for each scalar. If this you make the product of each scalar with the two vectors, and then you sum it up at the end, yeah. So in this case we can use this because the scalar product also works in MATCAD, so that's why I can we can use this as well. But it's, I think it's not so easy to understand, yeah. If it's again, if you would like to make this worksheet for documentation purpose, then this might be not a good idea, yeah, to write it that way. I think the most of the people will not understand, yeah, what you mean with this. I think this might be easier to understand, this one or this one here. So okay, the last two values are quite easy to calculate, so let's do this. This is the total thermal resistance, and the formula I have already here, so I just copy it, and yeah, I enter my mass region, give it a name. I think it was RT. Make a declaration, and I just insert the formula, and now I evaluate this, and also the unit. Can I? It's the same unit like here. Okay, so that's okay, the same unit. So we can copy this from here. Here we are. And the last value will this one. This is actually the U-value, and yeah, let's call it U, make the declaration, and it's actually 1 to RT, and evaluate this. And here we have to change the units to watt, and then divided by this one here. Das A, ja, so again, so watt divided by this, and then here we are. So far about this. Yeah, what was new in this example, on this tutorial? Maybe let's change the layout. So, and zoom a little bit out. So, I have shown you how can you work with vectors or with tables. Yeah, maybe to create values, let's say a value structure. Yeah, like the layers, the thickness of the wall layers, and the how was it the name of this the conductivity. Yeah, and I have shown you how you can calculate with such vectors. Yeah, some different ways I introduced in this tutorial. Now it's up to you which you prefer. And I think the rest was not so interesting. What was also interesting, before I forget this, it was the origin. Yeah, this is a quite a very difficult setup. Yeah, concerning the when you work with where was it? Here, no, here is it. When you work with matrices or with vectors. Yeah, the origin. Yeah, keep in mind, I always use one. It's up to you if you want to change it to zero. And also, I introduced some built-in functions, yeah, to find out how long or what is the last index of your vector. Yeah, this is this one here, and you find those built-in functions. Here are functions, and here you find them for vectors and vector and matrix. And if you go to all functions, yeah, you can also find it here. And from here, you can also use it. Yeah, and you maybe also have some small explanation. Yeah, if I hover over it, then it shows you some small explanation to these functions. It is also possible from here. Yes, it's also possible from here. So it's actually, there's no need to go to this function browser. Okay, thank you for your attention, and maybe see you in another tutorial.